Bade before foundation. We have to come amen, the first love, the commandment of the Lord. How is established, how he established in the Old Testament, his church, his people. Listen, hear the voice of the Lord for your life. Hear what the Lord said, church, because when the Lord speaks, it's because something is moved in the physical environment and the spiritual environment. Wake. Wake.
Dios los bendiga. Soy miembro de la iglesia Nueva Vida en Cristo. Estoy acá para dar un testimonio de lo que me ha pasado la semana pasada. Tenía un dolor tan intenso de cabeza que no lo podía soportar. Una semana andaba desconcentrada, desesperada, y yo pensaba en el doctor, pero el líder me llamó: vamos a orar en el altar, hermano, vamos a orar. Todos los hermanos oraron fervientemente y me quebranté también. Y de una manera u otra, yo no tenía dolor de cabeza, no está. Dios me sanó, gloria a Dios, la gloria para nuestro Señor Jesucristo. Gloria al Padre, al Hijo y al Espíritu Santo. Amén.
Morning church, God bless you everybody. Welcome to New Life in Christ family, amen. It's exciting for me to start this Sunday in his presence. Thank you, Father, for this beautiful moment, everybody. So welcome, so welcome, so welcome. And let's go church, amen, coming and praying, amen. Like the Lord spoke to us, everything and praying. Let's go coming and praying and give you the welcome to the beautiful Holy Spirit. Everybody knows, everybody, people who watch us, who will watch this video, and all the disciples, we know this is the ministry of the Holy Spirit in this earth, New Life in Christ. It's his ministry. He is the pastor and the prophet for this ministry. Let's go coming and praying and tell him how beautiful he is. Holy Spirit, you are so welcome, welcome to your ministry, New Life in Christ, your ministry, Holy Spirit. Come and in charge this ministry. This time is your beautiful. We recognize you like a pastor and the prophet, the leader. We follow you, Holy Spirit. You are our Lord in this house. You are who glorified the name of Yeshua. Holy Spirit, you are beautiful. We needed you. Tell him how much we needed. We needed you. All congregation, all your disciples needed you, Holy Spirit. You are so welcome. Beautiful you are. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Manifest your glory and blessing us with your beautiful word today. In the name of Yeshua, amen and amen. So, church, amen, the Holy Spirit is beautiful, it's amazing, it's powerful. Let's go, amen, worship him, worship Jesus, amen, for what he beautiful work he did in this earth. So let's go invite, amen, the worship band and worship him.
Thank you.
Hello, church. Amen. Welcome, welcome again to New Life in Christ family. And let's go start with the teaching and hear what the voice of the Lord, what the Lord said, what the Holy Spirit said to the Church of Christ today, this morning. And let's go, amen. Open the eyes, open the ear, amen, for what the word of the Lord today, because he has a powerful word today, and he will teach each one of us. The Holy Spirit is with each one of us, church, and he wants and is teaching us how we can fight against the all attack of the enemy. We are in this powerful teaching about the establishment of the first church and the Old Testament, and we are, amen, learning about the courses of emeries, amen, the emeries and the relationship and the family. This is, amen, a courses the generation and generation, amen, in this earth. The family has many problems, bad relationship, and all when we are a witness for that and when experience that in the family, we know through the word of the Lord, this is the curses in the family, I mean, that bad relationship. So we can see in the Old Testament there are history in the book of Exodus, and this history happened with Joshua and Moses. When the Hebrew people, when the Israelite people, amen, was in the will of the Lord and trying to, amen, fulfill the promise of the Lord in their life. And when they went to conquer the promised land, the Lord promised to the grandpa, amen, the parents, Abraham, Isaac, and Joseph, and they was in the will of the Lord to go and conquer the promise for their life. And that was the promised land, the Lord promised, amen, to Abraham, his descendant will be the people who will conquer this promised land. The Lord will give it to them for their faithfulness, for their obedience. So when they was went through with and they was led through Moses, so they get it, they experience these problems or this bad relationship. And not them was the people of Amalek who went to against them and trying to stop them. And trying to stop them conquer the promised land. So that is the history, amen, the Lord is bringing to us and show us how this evil spirit now in the New Testament trying to stop, amen, the purpose of the Lord in this earth with his people. The spirit always trying to stop the church grow, the church spread the gospel, the church establish his kingdom in this earth, the Lord kingdom in this earth through this spirit. So let's go see. We'll read the book of Exodus, chapter 17, verse 9 to 16.
And Moses said to Joshua, "Choose us some men and go out and choose us some men and go out, fight with Amalek. Tomorrow I will stand on the top of the hill with the rod of God in my hand." So Joshua did as Moses said to him and fought with Amalek. And Moses, Aaron, and Hur went up to the top of the hill. And so it was when Moses held up his hand that the Israelites prevailed. And when he let down his hand, Amalek prevailed. But Moses' hand became heavy, so they took a stone and put it under him, and he sat on it. And Aaron and Hur supported his hands, one on one side and the other on the other side, and his hands were steady until the going down of the sun. So Joshua defeated Amalek and his people with the edge of the sword. Then the Lord said to Moses, "Write this for a memorial in the book and recount it in the hearing of Joshua, that I will utterly blot out the remembrance of Amalek from under heaven." And Moses built an altar and called its name, "The Lord is my banner." For he said, "Because the Lord has sworn, the Lord will have war with Amalek from generation to generation."
Amen. So wow. So let's go see, amen, what we can learning about this history, amen, how the spirit, amen, evil spirit entering these people of Amalek. Listen, I will clarify something. The devil uses who allow Joseph. I mean, you can be believer, you can love the Lord, but if you allow the devil use your life against, I mean, the purpose of the Lord, that will happen. The Lord, you, the devil use whatever door open. So in the devil, the spirit, entering these people, Amalek, for God, right, and fight against the Hebrew people and stop what the Lord spoke to them. I mean, so Let's go see, amen. We'll study Bible word through Bible word and see what the Lord show us how fight with the spirit. Amen. How we can stop the spirit. Amen. When coming and fight, you know, with the Church of Christ. So let's go see the first Bible word or the first verse, and it's Exodus 9, 17, 9.
And Moses said to Joshua, choose us some men and go out and fight with Amalek. Tomorrow I will stand on the top of the hill with the rod of God in my hand.
Amen. So the Lord said, choose a some men and go out, fight with this Amalek. So the Lord first, the Lord spoke to Moses, tell Joshua. Joshua was the right hand of Moses and told him, and go and choose, amen. 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 Like the Lord said, choose the warrior, right? Who will fight. Amen. The people who is good, if we, right, trying to explain now with the church, with every ministry, because that fight, this battle is for every ministry of Christ in this earth, for every ministry, amen, for every church, always will experience that fight with this spirit, amen. So the Lord spoke to Joshua, or Moses told Joshua, choose, amen, all the warriors, all the people who are available to fight, all the strong people, every believer, amen, who are available to fight, who are good in front of the Lord, every people who knows what they doing, who knows how fight with the sword of the spirit, amen. So, and the Lord go and Moses go and told Joshua for, you know, bring all the valiants, amen, who will fight, who will be in the front and defend, amen, the kingdom of the Lord, defend, amen, the purpose of the Lord, defend the ministry of the Lord. So, you know, we'll study Bible word to Bible word for see, amen, how, you know, the organization or the strategy the Lord give it to Moses, how, amen, destroy the spirit, amen, because that is given to us, amen. If the Lord is choosing us for one purpose, amen. Everybody who is available to fight, everybody who is available to fight with the praying, with the fasting, with the holiness, against the spirit, who trying to stop the purpose of the Lord. I know you and me, we are so jealous with the kingdom of the Lord. And we have to fight, we'll fight, amen, for honor him, amen. For everybody who was like a King David, who was so jealous with the Lord, who was staying against the army of the Lord, amen. At that time was Saul with all the army. He was jealous and he was available to give you his life for fight, amen, and defend the army of the Lord. That is why the reason King David fight with the giant, amen, with the giant, and kill him. So the Lord said, okay, go and choose all the valiant, choose all the valiant, all who is available to fight, everybody who will defend, amen, the honor of the Lord. The Lord don't need that, but we, amen, like a soldier of the Lord will fight. When you are soldier of the army of your country, you are available to give your life for your country and fight against the benefit of your country. The same thing is in the kingdom of the Lord. Amen. When we are now experiencing this fight with that spirit, you are the valiant who the Lord has chosen. Amen. For his purpose, you are the valiant who the Lord, amen, is called for fight against this spirit. So don't feel discouraged. Don't feel like overwhelmed, because you know you are one the Joseph is chosen, right? Choose for fight against that spirit. So Moses commanded to Joshua to choose the warriors out of the people, those who were prepared and willing to defend the people from any attack. Amen. You are who the valiant who fight for the ministry, who fight, amen, for the congregation, who fight for all the spirit wanna do against, amen, the purpose of the Lord. Church, if we don't fight for that, who will defend, amen, the ministry, the purpose, the property of the Lord? Amen. And everything is about it. I am so jelly with all the stuff of the Lord. I don't know if you know that, but I am so jelly and straight with what is property of the Lord, with his church, with his people, with his ministry, because that is, I give you my life to him. Amen. And we are who defend him, like King David, amen, who will permit nobody coming, amen, and damage what is him. I know the Lord has the power for fight for himself, but we give you to the life, and we have to, amen, confirms that, to fight and pray, amen, against the whatever attack of the enemy, amen. So that they might go out and fight against his spirit of Amalek, amen. So Moses will be at the top of the hill, amen, that is in the presence of God, amen, and to listen the God direction to lead Joshua and the stranger that God will give him on how to overcome this spirit, amen. So the part of this Bible word said, the Lord told Joshua, go and choose all the men for fight. And I will be, he said, I will be staying on the top of the hill with the rod of God in my hands. Amen. With the stick of the Lord, it's better for me, of the Lord in my hands. That stick was signified authority, power. Amen. That signified the stick of the Lord. So see how word is the strength the Lord give you. Moses go to the presence of the Lord, to the mountain that signified, amen, with the authority of the Lord in his hands. And Joshua downs, right? And what can the field, right? And move forward and fight. One up and one down, the strength of the Lord. So the Lord show us for fight against the spirit of Amalek. We have to first go to the presence of the Lord. Be in his presence and praying, fight and praying. And not just for this spirit, for whatever situation, church. We have to pray for whatever circumstance, whatever situation. And down in the air, we have to do it. Everything we can do it in our force. Amen. No, we don't say, oh, Lord, we pray and we cross the arm and we wait in him. No, we have to pray and move to, and effort to, and the physical inviting. So that is the strategy. First, the spiritual. First is the presence of the Lord. We cannot run away. We cannot do nothing. We have to first go to his presence, because in his presence, and when Moses was received direction, was and with the authority, with the stick of the Lord, for how he used it, the authority he have, how he can move, amen, for fight against that situation. And that is not just for the ministers, for the family, for the head of the house, amen, for all the family, for the head of the house, how, you know, the Lord has given you a powerful strategy, how the believer, how the Christian people has to move in whatever circumstance, in whatever battle. Who don't have battle in this earth? Everybody experiences battle, circumstance, situation. But the first point is go to the presence of the Lord, amen, and over there, we receive the strategy, we receive the direction for how we can move, you know, here in this earth and the physical. What you provoke in the spiritual environment, you will see in the physical environment. Amen. That is so powerful, church. So powerful. The Lord is given to us. Amen. So let's go continue. See the next Bible word, Exodus 17:10.
So Joshua did as Moses said to him and fought with Amalek. And Moses, Aaron, and Hur went up to the top of the hill.
Amen. So let's go see, amen. So Joshua did as Moses said to him and fought with Amalek. And Moses and Aaron and Hur was up on the top of the hill. So Joshua was a man. Fought and fight, amen, with him, with Amalek. And they were, and Moses and Aaron was, the Moses not was by himself, was with Aaron, with a couple guys, amen, with Aaron and Hur. And they were going to the hill, amen, and be in there, and waiting in there, amen. And the same time when Moses was moved downstairs. So church, amen, for my experience in all this situation, because we have battle now, and I believe every church is battle with Amalek, Because Amalek always trying to stop, amen, like I said, the spiritual growth in the church, amen, the physical growth in the church, in whatever vision the church have in this earth, always the church of Christ in this earth fight with Amalek. How important is every pastor, amen, every leader be like a Moses, amen, and not just him, was we with two guys, amen. There was maybe like a support, like a, with all the elders in the church, amen, the pastor, being the presence of the Lord, with a group, amen, of people who is close to them and praying and hear, amen, and give you the direction to the army of the Lord. So Joshua represents like the army, amen, the valiant, the people, amen, all the congregation, amen. And obedient and hear what the pastor, what the leader say when they hear for what the Lord is command, amen. So one, like there was synchronized, I can say, right? Organize, amen, and fight together. No, the Bible don't say that the Moses was, you know, went through leave at one altar and Joshua was doing whatever he wants. No, there was in one body, amen, of Christ. They was doing in obedience and submission. So we can see that Joshua represent the obedience of the people, or all the people, amen. And what Moses was is speak from the Lord, what Moses was hearing from the Lord. Let's go see what the teaching say. Joshua, obedience, Joshua, obedience represents the obedience of the people who were attentive to what Moses was saying on behalf of God. While Moses in the spirit atmosphere was in the presence of God, mean that is on the summit of the hill, listening to the voice of God to lead the people, Joshua was listening to Moses and fighting, amen. So the obedience of Joshua, right, talking to, you know, redeem and destroy Amalek in this earth. So Joshua represent the obedience, represent the people, represent the valiant, amen, who was here from Moses for destroy the spirit in there, amen. So we can see how the Lord was give you that strategy, Lord. And when the church is moved and obedient and hear and the voice of the Lord, amen, through the leader, right, we can destroy whatever spirit is coming and attack to us. But when somebody is doing something, somebody is busy, when not attends and the people is with distraction, or the people is doing different in another page, another, amen, I don't know, another business, then the pastor, rather, they don't will conquer, they don't will win the battle, amen? Because everybody is like in division, is in different, in disconnection. And listen to me, when the spirits attack the church, amen, we can see when somebody is weakened, and when somebody is more worrying for their own personal life, and somebody is in another business, you know, the spirit will come in and found it by self with weakness, amen? And will destroy the spirit, because it's not in the group of the army. It's not in the group of value. It's no fight in the group together. Amen. So it's because coming the discouraged, amen, coming the weakness in the people. And what happened is the next who the spirit Amalek read it from the group. Pay attention to that. Amen. And because we have to pray, amen, and fight for all, right, the people, right, who maybe is not strong in the faith and for pushing them and continue follow the Lord. In this time, right, when the church, the spirit attacked to the church and trying to paralyze, bring discouragement, bring sickness, bring many things for the people to stop seeking the Lord and give up, amen, and run away. Amen. So let's go continue. Amen. This is so interesting because we can learn more point about this teaching, amen? So let's go, you prepare maybe Exodus 12 and 13, amen? Or 12.
Exodus
12. I don't know if you have, okay. So, no, one moment, please. In Yeah, you can please. It's better you do that now.
Read? Okay. But Moses' hands became heavy, so they took a stone and put it under him, and he sat on it. And Aaron and Hur supported his hands, one on one side and the other on the other side. And his hands were steady until the going down of the sun.
I mean, so listen, how was the Lord so smart? Everything in his word is powerful. You know what? Why the Lord was sent, amen, Moses with Ur, right? Hur and Aaron, because the Lord knows Moses will get tired, amen, because the word of praying, amen, I would tell you sometimes make you more tired than the physical battle, church. So Moses was embarrassed in that moment by the spiritual realm and praying, right? And the sign was lift up his hands in the presence of the Lord. That signified, amen, the battle. He was, amen, provoked in the spiritual realm, and he was getting tired because, yeah, it's true that make it tired the physical body and the spiritual body. So that was the reason why the Lord permitted, not just Joshua, you know, with the elders in the church, if we can say that, right? With the people who are more mature, with the people who are strong in the faith, for, you know, hold the hands, amen, of him, because they know when we come, amen, they will get it tired. And that way, you know, the praying is more powerful when the praying is in group, right? When the all the believer, when all everybody unified in praying, I mean, it's more powerful. It's when everybody is one page. So the leader get it tired, but there was two. I mean, one to one side and another to another side who was, you know, hold their hands for continue, like give you the four and the praying for him. In short, and that's it's incredible. It's incredible because I was experienced that. I mean, how the warfare pray. Bring, amen, bring, make you so tired and exhausted, amen, because you are fight with one spirit, amen, and when you fight, it's move thing in the spiritual environment. So that what happened with Moses, amen, he get so tired, and these two people was support, and how, and they say when the Moses, can you repeat the last part when they say when the Moses was prayed, there was prevail, Israel was prevail.
And so it was, this verse 11, and so it was when Moses held up his hand that Israel prevailed, and when he let down his hand, Amalek prevailed.
Amen. So when Moses was with the people who were held to him and praying, amen. So in the result was in the spiritual environment, the physical, Israel was prevailed. Amen. So how important for us is the praying, and how important church in a one, I mean, is play this is pray, amen, for the leader, for the pastor, amen. Of the church, and then I don't know if he has courses because I can experience many church never the people pray for the pastor, amen. And that's a and I can see in my old church when I was disciple always the same problem, the people pray for all the worries or they want they need and never pray for the pastor, amen. And we can see through Moses he was getting tired, and this couple guy was hold his hands, amen. This battle is make it tired. I mean, and sometimes the people don't understand how important is prayer. And not I say because I am pastor. I experienced this problem when I was in my church. My pastor was, I think he get so sick and so in bad condition. But more was for the spiritual battle. I mean, and it was complaining that people never was prayed for them. And I see, wow, how Satan always in many congregations, amen, the people pray for their things they needed, they want, and never pray for the leader. And it's something, you know, incredible because they don't know if the leader fell, the all the church will fail and will go to, will be, I mean, a worldly church, will be, everything will fail. I mean, I remember when my pastor get it with that, the church get it so much, what I can say. A confusion in a mess, a church, amen. So We can see through Moses, right? The capo guy was holding his hands because he was getting tired. So that show us, I mean, the strategy for, you know, win the spirit, you have to pray for the leader, for support, right? And pray in church because, yeah, the church, the Lord called, not just the pastor, all the church be a part for one body of Christ. And I know we needed, we have many things for what pray. But we, the Lord, the Bible said, pray for your leaders, pray for the king, pray for the for your city, pray for the president, for all the authority the Lord put in front to us. I mean, it's very important. Pray for that and support and pray. So we can see when they was hold the hands of Moses, and he will continue fight right in the spiritual realm. The result will be Joshua was destroyed, amen, killed all Amalek in this earth. So that's the Bible never make a mistake, church. It's incredible. I feel sometimes like I living in the Bible. I live in what the Bible say, amen. In every situation in the ministry. So let's go say the next. Let's go see the next Bible word. I think it will be 13.
So Joshua defeated Amalek and his people with the edge of the sword.
Amen. So Joshua defeated Amalek and his people with the edge of the sword. We know mercy and compassion. Amen. The Lord told him, read him that. You know, that people, that's, I believe, right, in the past, in the Old Testament, these people, the Amalek people, provoked the anger of the Lord. Remember, we are studying the family group. What happened when we provoke the anger of the Lord? What happened when we provoke his anger, burning fire will come in and destroy everything. I believe these people provoke the anger of the Lord in their life. And what happened, the Lord permit Joshua with no compassion, really be destroyed. Amen. All these people with his sword, amen, with no compassion, with violence, amen, Joshua, and coming and destroy everything. The same thing, we don't have mercy or compassion of this spirit. Because the kingdom of the darkness no has mercy or compassion of us. And we have to destroy and rid of it with our sword. And that signifies the word in our mouth, the praying. The Lord give you the authority. The Lord give you to us in this earth. And destroy the spirit, amen. And rid of it. Because the force for a stop, amen. The purpose of the Lord, mighty and powerful. And already the Lord spoke to us, you know, a war against the spirit. And the Lord will give you to us the victory. We just have to obey in all the strategy the Lord give you to Joshua, to Moses, for how destroy the spirit of this earth. Amen. So let's go see Exodus 17, 14 to 17.
Then the Lord said to Moses, write this for a memorial in the book of and recount it in the hearing of Joshua, that I will utterly blot out the remembrance of Amalek from under heaven. And Moses built an altar and called its name, the Lord is my banner. For he said, because the Lord has sworn, the Lord will have war with Amalek from generation to generation.
Amen. So already the Lord spoke, right? Because Amalek, not because the Hebrew people, amen, stand against that, because the Lord has the Lord right spoke, right? Because they, Amalek, stand against that, the Hebrew people who has battle. There's something that's already spoke in the Old Testament. That was the Lord Almighty from generation to generation. So that is why the Lord has called us to fight against that spirit, because, you know, that will happen in the Old Testament, that bad relationship, not for the Hebrew people, for these people, for Amalek people, amen. And that has provoked a huge, like I said, courses until now, amen, to fight with the spirit, amen, who enter. Listen to me, not let the, they don't want to say the spirit coming and fight with us. The spirit enter and people who allow, who open the door for that. And because you see people, you never meet with them. You don't know nothing about the people that maybe live against you. Maybe your neighbor, and you say, what happened? I don't did nothing to my neighbor. It's one evil spirit. Amen. So Amalek was our one people who was the, later we'll see about it more about the Amalek, but it was formed, that was a group of people, amen, who was in the wilderness, amen. And they come in too for one, a family of, Later we'll study more about it for what family come in the city of Amalek. But you know, they come just with nothing, for any reason to attack the Hebrew people. Amen. But that was one evil spirit, and they opened the door for that. The same thing, that is the point I want to explain to you. You know, there maybe somebody stand against you and fight with you, and you don't know, you never, you know, attack these people, you never, you don't know nothing about these people. But like I told you, the devil uses who is allowed, who opened door for Joseph. Amen. The devil knocking the door, if you open, you can be the people who will stand against the purpose of the Lord. Amen. Because you open the door for that, that happened with these people. So already, you know, the Lord spoke one word. And so Amalek, the Lord, the Bible said, who has, you know, battle with Amalek from generation to generation. And then one important point in this Bible word, because the Lord has sworn, right?
Sworn.
Amen. So the Lord will has warm, right? With Amalek generation. So, but I say the Lord, not us. So for that word, I can see it's the Lord who fight our battle. We just want to follow what did Moses, what did, amen, and Joshua, obedient, be in his presence, receive from the Lord, amen, the direction for what we do at the next service, for what we do it, amen, the next day, how we'll do it, amen. We just obey and be in his presence, and the Lord is who, amen, will fight, because say the Lord who has battle with Amalek, amen, no you and no me. We just instrument in his hands, amen,
amen,
for all this battle. And the Lord, right, and say, and Moses built an altar and called his name. The Lord is my banner, amen. The Lord, amen. You can see in this Bible, you can find it like that, but in the Spanish Bible, you can see that Jehovah, amen, Nisi, Jehovah Nisi, amen. So the Lord is giving to us all the strategy, amen, how to fight, amen, with the spirit, who has a bad relationship, amen, through the Amalek people, with the people of the Lord. So there are courses already spoken from the Old Testament, and we are, amen, apart from this, because now all the church, and not just New Life in Christ, all the church who has battled with this spirit. But the Lord said, write this in one book. How is the Lord beautiful, right? To Moses, all this history, because I know my people in the New Testament, New Life in Christ, amen, who has battle. So write all in this book, amen, and lift up an altar and put in there Jehovah Nisi, because the Lord will fight the battle, amen, with this spirit. So the Lord, knowing all the church who has the battle, listen, how is that, right? We can find in the Bible how fight with the spirit of Amalek, amen. So we have to church to pray for all the people, amen, because that spirit is what I can say, that light betraying you. They're coming from the coming in attack to all the wickedness in the church, to all the people maybe who is not the warrior, all the people maybe who is not ready to fight, all the people who now is with wickedness. So coming from that, they don't come in to the pastor, they don't maybe come in to the elders, to the people who is, amen, mature with character. They will come in for the place, amen, when the people is the people, right, with wickedness, with the people who know is not strong in the faith, with the people maybe with a new believer, maybe the people, right, who has who are battle and is tired now to fight so much, people who has a lot of spiritual neglect. And because I tell you, amen, we have to take care of all the people we have in the church, for they don't get it discouraged, for they don't get it discouraged to continue follow the Lord, because that the spirit come. The spirit is white and all trying to be treated, coming from the back, from the place, amen. The church, maybe the people or the congregation, maybe is not ready to fight, amen. So it's many, you know, points we can learn about this spirit, amen. So church, this is the teaching for today, and I know the Lord spoke to us, each one of us, and I know you are, amen, the warrior, The Lord is looking for, amen. You are who will fight for him, and you are who defend, amen, his ministry, his church, amen. So church, God bless you so much, and let's go come in one short prayer for, amen, done this service, and tell and praise in the Holy Spirit for his teaching, because he is good. Holy Spirit, thank you so much. You are our leader. You are our pastor. Thank you so much for your word. And I pray, Father God, for each one of us, for your people today, Lord, take the decision, Father God, seeking you more, Lord, and being you present and understanding that it has to be in your presence for receive all the direction for their own family, for their own job, for their own situation, Lord, and not just in the battle with us against the spirit. It's in all the situation we have to go. We have to go to your presence, Lord, with the stick, with the authority you give it to us, like your children, Father God, like your son, and receive from you first before we go out, Lord, and do it and go to work, before we do it, whatever things, every morning, Lord, every day be in the mountains, Lord, in your presence with authority, Lord. You give it to us like your children, Father God, in faith, Lord, and receive from you first for conquer, Father God, for overcome whatever battle, including the day we have, Lord, in everything in our life, Lord. Thank you, Father God, and move like a Joshua too, Lord, in faith, Father, and do what is possible, and you will do what is impossible. Thank you, Lord, in the name of Yeshua, amen, amen. So God bless you, each one of our church. Thank you so much for this time. God bless you, and I see you soon. Thank you.